Hello everyone! In one of our previous videos, we looked at two obfuscation plugins from the GOAT project. In this episode, we will compile the JPanic plugin that generates junk instructions and will make it compatible with the latest GCC version. In the previous part, we've seen that it was easier to install an older version of GCC because the plugin, as the author mentions on the website, is only supported until version of GCC 4.9. On this machine, we have version 9.3. GCC and G++ version 9.3. And as we'll see, there are a lot of differences in terms of the code. A lot of function names have been changed. A lot of the logic and class hierarchies have changed as well. And we have to adapt the code. Before seeing the differences in parallel, we'll go through the plugin code because it is actually very interesting and will be useful if introducing new features. There were also some include files that had to be edited, which we'll see in a moment. So I've updated the plugin version number in this structure for clarity. The base version field is very important. This represents the correct GCC version that the plugin will run with. Then here's an enum, which is basically a list of types of junk instruction that can be added. Then I defined string values for all of them. Next, an array that will store functions that are inserted throughout the code. Let's go through some of the more interesting parts of the code. For example, this function, which will build a junk assignment. This one will build some random mathematical operation, which don't affect the code. This part of the code is interesting as well. It will create a new function with random instructions inside. This function is completely not used at all. It is just for code confusion. Then some helper functions to locate a function inside an array and then to decide if the function is junk or not. That's one of the interesting parts that change between versions. The number of fields in this pass data structure and their types have changed, so I took this one from the newest version. Then I had to change the logic a bit. There is a function called execute, which is very important and gets called once per each actual function, while the code is being translated from source code to an intermediate representation. To understand what happens, first we have the initialization of the plugin, and then for each statement in each block, we decide randomly, based on this value, whether to insert a junk instruction or not. If we decide to do so, and we haven't reached the maximum number of junk instructions, we will choose randomly between the types of junk instructions previously defined. So we can either have a junk assignment, junk arithmetic instructions, new function, a call to an old function, and that's it. After we select it, we insert it into the tree and it will end up in the code. Magic! This part is also important, the plugin initialization function. I had to change this code a bit as well. Notice that in this function, we take care of the parameters and we parse the parameter NaJunk, which is passed as an argument from the command line. In this portion of the code, although you see here 4.9, doesn't actually matter. It's just for getting the length of the version string. So let's first clean this folder because we built it before using make clean. Let's remove the two previous executables as well. Okay, the folder is clean. We'll issue the make command to build the plugin. Now we have the plugin file. Let's see how to compile new programs with the plugin. We need to specify the plugin on the command line and each of its arguments. In this case, there is only one. Let's see how it works. Generate an output file named junk1. You see in this case, three arithmetic instructions were randomly chosen. Let's generate another one. In the second one, we also have arithmetic instructions. Let's try another one. Now there are some assignments as well and new functions created. Let's see another one. A good mix of instructions and functions called. If we check the MD5 hashes for those files, all of them should be different. Okay, to make sure we got this correct, let's have a look in IDA Pro. And we'll check the last one. This is one of the junk functions that we've introduced. Then we have a lot of junk instructions over here. This was one of the functions defined manually. And we have a few instructions here as well. Not that many. All right. And let's also compare the code between this version and the previous version of the plugin. We can see there are a lot of differences based on the highlighting colors. We have a new include file, which is necessarily in the new version. We have updated the plugin version number, the GCC version as well. We've added some strings to better understand what's happening and print some debugging messages. The most important changes are in this namespace and specifically when defining the pass_data structure. And also this function has been rewritten from scratch and introduced in a different part of the code. That's basically it, and probably converting the other plugins in the Goat project would require a similar level of parsing. If you're curious, take some time and play with the other plugins in this project and see if you can make them work with the newest compiler versions. Thank you very much for watching, and if you find this useful, please subscribe and share it with your friends. Cheers!